Good evening, folks. Welcome to tonight's game between the Michigan Wolverines and the North Carolina Tar Heels. And, of course, we look here at our star watch. And there are the starting lineups for each team.
There are two solid power forwards that will be matched up against one another. Yes, it'll be a treat to watch them battle on both ends of the court. They both have the potential to take control of the paint and the game.
We got the potential for fireworks here today as two of the top teams in the country are getting ready to get things going.
I tell you, Brad, it's going to be a real treat to watch. This is going to be a great story. Two top-ranked teams. My question is, who's going to be the difference maker, Brad?
The Tar Heels are number 5 in the polls right now, Dick.
Great, great play on the interior. Their post people really know how to take advantage of breakdowns by the defense, and that's why they're in the top 25.
Knocks it down. And now getting set up in a 5-out.
Well, I tell you, I like the 5-out spread. If you got people that can really put the ball on the deck, you spread the court and you try to beat them off the dribble.
Turnover by the senior. Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Down inside with the J. Off the mark. Coach wants them to set up offensively now. Lobs it.
Oh, did they ever set that alley-oop nicely, Brad.
Brooks receives the pass. And up, but he missed it. Robinson receives the ball. Dumps it in. That's why I love this game, Dick, for that reason alone.
The Ruckus fans are going nuts. They're going bananas, Brad.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
They've got him right where they want him, Richard. On the left side. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. On the dribble, gives it up. He manages to keep it in play. There is no play that includes that guy in the stands. Baseline inbounds. Now they work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. You betcha. What a pass on the backdoor cut.
There's nothing like a well-timed backdoor cut and pass. I'm sure they practice that all the time.
Williams receives the pass. And we'll get a change of possession. So the pass will come in from the baseline. There's a bad pass right to the defender. Now on the run. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Here's the drop step in the low block.
Oh, he does a great job using his footwork to get over the top of the defensive player.
Goes up with it. Jumper won't go. From way outside. Missed it. Gave it up. He wants a three and come up short. Working it around the perimeter. For the bucket. He hits it. Jumper. He seems determined to take the tough shot.
But they're not falling, and the offense is being totally taken out of sync.
Nope. Williams handles the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. The man asking for a screen here.
Hey, whether it ends up in a roll or fade, its well-executed two-man game is always a treat to watch.
Out on the right wing, in the lane. The missed shot. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
The sideline has been trying to get the team to play more up-tempo. The coaches feel that this is the style that they need to play and will work for them. Definitely something for us to track moving forward, Brad.
Thanks, EA. Aaron Andrews providing that extra bit of insight for us. The shooting guard takes the pass.
Turnover by the freshman.
The Wolverines looking to attack now in transition. Goes up for two. He gets the shot to fall. We'll see who's got more coming out of this timeout as play resumes. They're going to call that a backcourt violation.
Somebody got a little nervous that time, Brad.
Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
He shoots from the deep corner. Doesn't go. Zone motion now. Gave it up. From the corner. Missed the jumper. Will this zone continue to be effective, you think?
Yeah, sure it will, Brad. Unless the offense steps up and starts hitting some long-range jumpers.
Yeah, that might be their only solution. Nails the J.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Great defensive play rotating over. Played that screen really well up on top.
Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what she's got in store for us. Aaron?
Coach has been quite animated over here on the sidelines. It's all positive, though. He's pleased with the manner in which they're playing their up-tempo style. I overheard him saying that if this continues, he likes his team's chances. Guys?
Thanks, EA, our third member of our team, providing that additional insight. Robinson handles the pass. Puts up the J.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Williams receives the pass. Off the mark. They work it around the perimeter.
Unusual mistake there by the senior.
Takes his jumper. Williams isn't getting much help from his teammates, but he is managing to get things done himself.
This is a one-man show right now, Brad. This is supposed to be a team game.
They work the perimeter. He puts up the J. Scorches the net with a J. On the dribble, gives it up. He puts up the three ball. Can't connect. Brooks handles the pass. Turnaround jumper. Missed it. Williams receives the ball. Jumper. They got it. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. From the top of the key. Bust the jumper. On the outside. Looks at a three. Gets the J to fall. He puts up the tray. Knocked it down. Momentary look from three-point land.
Oh, what a high riser. Great vision. The fans love it. What a terrific play.
And the block. Out on the wing. And we're at the 8-minute mark. For two, it sticks. Looking for a good shot. He pulls up with a jumper. Nails a sweet jumper. With a jumper. He's not getting himself in position for the good shot.
Yeah, it's a little bit too much. One-on-one. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
This guy can really score in a variety of ways down on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, he can beat you face up or he can beat you with his back to the basket. He can step a few feet out and he's been able to convert. He's a tough, tough matchup.
Gave it up. Tries for two. Scorches the net. Both teams keeping it close. Both teams ranked in the top 25, playing some really good basketball, as expected, Dick.
You know, they both came out of the gates on a high level, and their play speaks for itself. Two really well-coached teams, and as you can see, the attention of the polls is well-deserved.
Gets it to fall. Working around the perimeter. Goes up with a shot. Scores it. Both teams looking to get things going here. On the wing, there's a double team waiting there. About 6 minutes remaining in the game clock. For the bucket, he misses the fadeaway. Sinks it. Up for two. He hits the shot. Looking to move it around the perimeter. With the J. Bust the J. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. The missed shot. On the dribble, gives it up. Miller picks up the foul. First personal foul. And let's take a look at a player who's really having a good game here tonight.
Wow, he's really elevated his game. A big-time player, scoring the basketball, doing it all. Just a special player. And you know, he's great to watch. Hey, a player's senior year is such an emotional one. The key is to stay focused and not get caught up on being in your last year of collegiate basketball. If you focus on the right things, win or lose, it'll be a memorable experience.
Gets the second shot. They've got him trapped. And we got a whistle and a foul. From the baseline, nails the jumper.
Look at that spacing.
He shoots from downtown, off the mark. Three-point territory.
Excellent jump shot right there.
About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. For two, knocks it down. Gave it up.
They're working hard on defense to get through those screens.
The defense is just getting caught out of position on those backdoor cuts, Dick.
I tell you, what a great play. That's coaching. That's teaching. That's terrific execution. The backdoor cut from the weak side.
Up and inside.
He shoots from the top of the circle. Nails the J. Looking for a good shot. He takes the fadeaway. We're at the 3 minute mark. He misses the fadeaway. And a slam. Moving it around the perimeter. And the jam. He looks for the bomb. And off the mark. Pushes it up. From 3-point range. Off the mark. The shooting guard gets the pass. He tries to knock down the three. Knocked it down. We're at the 2 minute mark. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He bombs from outside and come up short. There was no doubt about that one. They'll work it around the arc. Goes up. Scores it. On the outside. Tries for two. He buries the shot. Nice look on that backdoor pass, Dick.
Hey, when you can mix teamwork and execution, you get plays like that, Mr. Nestler.
across court. For the bucket. He gets that one to fall. And the intensity is definitely starting to grow with this crowd right now, Dick.
Hey, this is definitely one of the toughest places to play and get a win. The team, the crowd, the noise, this place has all the ingredients to make the visiting team's day a long one.
Off the inbound. Robinson has been negatively influenced by his play and the events which have unfolded here.
Things aren't coming easy for him right now. He's in a rut.
Goes up for two. He gets it to go. Shot clock is dead. For two. Off the glass and no good. Williams handles the pass. There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Let's it fly. Bust the J. At the end of the first half, the Tar Heels trail by one. North Carolina is not having the best of days on the boards in the first half.
Hey, subpar rebound and performance by this squad so far. Seems like everybody's waiting for someone else to grab the rock.
Like they're going to go with a full court man-to-man press, Dick. Tries for two. No good. Brooks receives the pass from the corner. Missed the jumper. Let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
The Tar Heels are fun to watch when they share the ball and spread out the attack. However, they have not done any of this so far. Dick, one of your points of emphasis was that they spread out the attack. Well, as you know, this hasn't happened yet, and most likely the reason why they trailed at the half. Look for them to get back to their preferred style of play. Brad?
All right, thanks, Aaron.
Shooter spotting up on a three.
He shoots from the corner. Misses from way outside. Trying to feed the low block.
I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
Now they work it around the perimeter. They got it. That's one of the best parts of college basketball, the student section. They're fired up and they're ready to try to help their team.
They look like they're having a blast.
Definitely a foul. He got the layup to go and the foul is called.
Hey, he saw that he was going to get fouled, but he stuck to the path in spite of it.
Potential for a three-point play. Makes it. Here comes the ball screen. Working it around the perimeter. He shoots the jumper. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
For the bucket, goes. On the dribble, gives it up. He attempts a three. Nope. On the right side. He attempts a jump shot. Busts the jumper.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. That was nice. He shoots from the deep corner.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot?
They work it around the perimeter. He tries the jumper. Gets the J to fall. He launches a three. Nails a sweet jumper. They work the perimeter. He tries the three ball. Nails the J. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. They get it to go. On the outside. Jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Loose ball and batted in. The Wolverines have been getting contributions from a whole bunch of players here today.
Everyone is getting a bout, and everyone is having a good time. The great thing about basketball is you don't always have to score to be a threat. Teamwork can help you win a lot of games.
The Tar Heels here running their zone offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Matt. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps of the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
The missed shot. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, that big guy they have that can step out and go inside is really special. He gives you that flexibility, which makes the offense multifaceted.
Out on the wing. Out of bounds and a change in possession. On the inbound play. He rejects it. Off the mark. And a momentary look from three-point land. Robinson manages to keep it in. That one finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. Goes up for two. Missed the jumper.
Nice hops.
The Wolverines set up into their zone motion offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Matt. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps of the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
That's a foul. I think that one deserves another look.
He took this one strong and hard, Mr. Nessler. That, my friend, makes a coach proud.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
Knowing there are guys on your team who know what you want and know what it takes to be successful is a big bonus. converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Looking for a good shot.
Double team now, bad angle.
I think he was there, Dick.
Yeah, but that could have gone either way.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, it's a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Out in the low block, trying to work the lane and come up short. Brooks receives the pass. And now they'll bring it up. Out on the wing. He looks for three. Off the mark. Barry handles the pass. For two. Tickles a twine. And it's blocked.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
From the top of the key.
They're going to find a way to get some easy buckets to get their confidence back, Brad.
Absolutely. They got to get it going here. Gave it up. Now looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns
the... The layup counts and the foul.
He went hard to the hoop knowing he was going to get fouled.
Well, Dick, here's a player in just his freshman year.
I tell you, what an exciting time in a young man's life. It's that student-athlete experience really preparing him for the rest of his life.
Hits that one. Well, this man's in trouble. Time out on the floor, folks. More ESPN coverage coming up right after this. I look for something different here coming out of this timeout, Dick.
I wouldn't doubt it, Brad.
The Wolverines set up into their zone motion offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is over...
Goaltending. Once again, let's take a look at our star watch. For two. He buries it. Teams will play all sorts of tempos and styles these days, Dick. What are some of the characteristics of up-tempo teams?
They definitely want to run, Brad. They want to run faster and longer than their opponents every time they step on a court. It's a style of play which is tough to keep up with.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He goes up with it. And score it.
Look at that spacing.
Puts up the jumper. Gets the J to fall.
There it is, Jam City.
Around 8 minutes remaining. for the bucket. It's good. Throws it up. Kicks it out. From the corner, knocks it down.
Backcourt violation call.
A little bit of a mental lapse by the offense that time, Dick. The double team to stop it. Takes the jumper. Dick, he's in a serious rhythm.
Hey, that's because he's getting the ball in rhythm, Brad. Very important.
On the dribble, gives it up. Seven minutes left on the game clock. He shoots from outside. Jumper won't go. The Tar Heels will probably be better off if they resort to playing in the half court for the rest of the game. Dick, given the time and score, playing up-tempo really isn't the smartest thing to do.
I think they'll look to settle down. They should be running longer offensive sets, which allow for the ball to move and the clock to wind down. I'll be surprised if there are any early shots.
The Wolverines move into their zone motion offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
At some point, his team is going to have to step up and play at his level. He's carrying them right now.
Inside. Turnover by the freshman. Gave it up. And they're in their motion offense, working with five out here, Dick.
I'll tell you, it's an opportunity for them to draw the opponent's big guy out to the perimeter. This will really open things up in the paint.
About 6 minutes remaining. Puts up the J. Nails a sweet jumper.
It inside.
Great hustle. Out of bounds, and we're staying right here. Let's take another look at this deep three. Inbound play on the baseline. The student body looks to be full with rage and willing to cheer on the old home team.
Isn't it great, Brad?
Tries for two with a layup. Play results in a backcourt violation.
You have to take care of the rock, baby.
In the post. Number four is whistled for the foul. Mary steps to the line for the first time. Up and in. Look good. Long lead pass. On the dribble, gives it up. Goaltending called. this man's in trouble. Picks off the pass. He shoots from the corner. He misses the jumper. Gave it up. The senior commits a turnover. On the left side. On the dribble, gives it up, unloads. What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
About 4 minutes remaining. He shoots from the top of the key. The missed shot. Looking for a good shot. For the bucket. Drains it. We've got a break in the action, folks. Stay tuned for more ESPN coverage of the NCAA. There might be a change in the game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition.
The Wolverines here running their zone offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Matt. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps of the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
Wow, what a finish on that back cut.
Great delivery on that back cut. He just hit him at the right time.
The Wolverines can't afford to have him pick up too many more fouls. And now getting set up in a five out.
Well, you know what I love about the five out? You take the big guy away from the goal, and you get a lot of motion on the offensive end, and it usually leads to great offensive efficiency.
On the left side. At least bad shots have a chance of going in. Moving it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. With a layup. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
From left of the circle. He makes the jumper. They'll work it around the arc. Makes it. How do you slow these guys up?
They've got to start hitting some shots on their own.
On the left side. Puts up the tray. He misses the fadeaway. Off the glass and no good. Jumper scorches the net with a J. On the outside. He unloads a three. He buries the jumper. The lead is 9.
Nine is fine, Brad. They have to keep their composure and take good shots.
Gave it up. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. Let's check out this three-pointer one more time, Dick. We're at the one-minute mark. Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Trying to execute on the inbounds.
And the clock stopped with a foul. You know, when a team shoots this well from the line, playing aggressive defense can come back to haunt you.
Hey, that means that they're doing a good job of practicing free throws.
Nothing but rim. Dumps it in. The turn to fadeaway jumper. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby. Good teams will get to the line often, but getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws.
With a long bomb. He strokes it, and he can't hit the shot. And the clock stopped with a foul. He'll have one and the bonus. Gets it. Perimeter. He puts up the J. Nope. Shot clock is dead. On the left side. Now trying to feed the low block. There's a whistle and a foul on the inside.
What a great job of putting the ball to the floor and attacking the basket, taking advantage of a slow post play.
Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
Well, the free throws go. Working it around the perimeter. He takes a three off the mark.
Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. And now let's take a look at our players of the game.
A real nice performance by both young guys. Some special players.